In the photo beside, we are able to observe there are two subjects in the middle, subject 1 being Marcel and subject 2 being Farameer. After analyzing, both subjects are leaning against each other, with subject 1 leaning against subject 2 to the right, as well as subject 2 leaning against the subject 1 to the left. Because of the state and position to which the subjects are in, they are exerting acceleration in two opposite directions because of their mass and the gravity to let them fall back. Not only that, but both subjects also include normal force, friction force, as well as gravitational force. For the second free body diagram, the photo here shows that a boy is sitting on a ledge. In this photo, it exemplifies yet more of normal force going upwards, gravitational force downwards, friction force with the boy's hand on the curved bit of the ledge, and also an unmentioned before, which is tension, where the boy is carrying a bag upwards. In Newton's first law of motion, or otherwise known as the law of inertia, it states that the state of motion in which an object is in will always be constant and will not change unless of an interrupting force that causes it to change. After analyzing the picture in front of you that is being shown right now, it can be concluded that there is Newton's first law of motion. This is due to the fact that the boy is in a state of rest on the ledge. Because there is no outside force interrupting, the boy's state of motion is still at rest and will remain at rest. Moving on to Newton's second law of motion, it describes the relationship between the force, acceleration, and mass of an object. It states that the acceleration of an object depends on those two things, as when a constant force acts upon a large body, it causes it to accelerate. In the case of the photo being shown right now, it is an example of the second law of motion. This is because the guy in the photo is showcasing acceleration as he runs along on the treadmill. The mass of the person acts as an important role, as the lighter or heavier the mass of the person, it directly affects how they run on the treadmill and how fast. Also considering the fact that the speed of the treadmill itself can be changed, which also affects other forces such as the friction on the person's feet on the sliding treadmill floor. The last of Newton's law of motion is the law of action and reaction. Action and reaction meaning that when two different objects interact with one another, they both exert force that is equal but the opposite in direction, thus giving it the title of action and reaction. In the case of the picture being shown to you right now, there is a guy who is leaning against a wall above the ground. The guy exerts force onto the direction of the wall for a certain amount of energy. And due to this, the wall also gives off the same amount of energy towards the direction of the guy, creating the action and reaction chain. Moving on from Newton's law of motion, we are going to go with energy, the first one being potential energy. Potential energy is very self-explanatory, but it is the energy in which an object or body holds within, therefore it being called potential energy. In this photo, the guy hanging on the wall contains potential energy. The potential energy exists because of the motion of the guy who's slowly slipping downwards. The photo can be analyzed, to which the potential energy can also be calculated. Predicted that the mass of the guy is 65 kilograms, gravitational acceleration of 9.8 meters per second square, and height of 2 meters. Using the formula of potential energy, which is PE equals m times g times h, we can substitute the formula with the given numbers. PE equals 65 times 9.8 times 2, resulting in a potential energy of 1274 joules. The second energy to discuss is kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy that an object has due to the state of motion that it is in. In the case of this photo, the guy running on the treadmill contains kinetic energy because he is in motion and moving. Predicting that the mass of the guy is 65 kilograms with a velocity of 2 meters per second, we are able to calculate the kinetic energy with the formula Ke equals half times m times v squared. Replacing the formula with the numbers, Ke equals half times 65 times 2 squared, the total kinetic energy is 130 joules. The last one will be conservation of energy. The law of conservation of energy is one that ties both potential and kinetic energy in the sense that both can neither be created or destroyed, but as a matter of fact, can only be transferred into another form of energy. In the example of this photo, the guy who's positioned a few meters above on the wall has potential energy stored because he's positioned high. There is the potential in which he can drop or fall down, releasing all that energy. Even though the guy is stationary, he is actually sliding down due to the friction between the surface of his sweater and the surface of the slippery wall. Because he is sliding downwards, the kinetic energy also exists. Because there is potential energy and kinetic energy, there is also the probability of having conservation of energy due to the fact that he starts from a zero motion or at rest, but as well going down into a motion to which he falls into the 0 meter point. Predicted that the mass of the guy is 65 kilograms, a gravitational acceleration of 10 meters per second square, and height of 2 meters, the potential energy from point A or before sliding down is 1300 joules and a kinetic energy with 0 joules. Because mechanical energy is the sum of both potential and kinetic, the total mechanical energy at point A is 1300 joules. Moving on to point B, or at which the guy is at 0 meters of height, the potential energy is 0 joules, a kinetic energy of 1300 joules, and a velocity of 40 meters per second squared. The mechanical energy for point B is 1300 joules. Because of this, it can be proven that the mechanical energy is always the same, but only transferred. Mechanical energy from point A and point B is the same, with 1300 joules in total. As students, we are our own visionary leader, and to be able to achieve our goals, we must be able to adapt to every possible situation handed to us. Without it, we won't be able to get to where we are now. To be able to truly understand something, you must learn the very fundamentals and basics of that something. The usage of physics has become very developed in the modern world, and it can be seen everywhere around us. Us as humans, we are able to analyze the smallest of details within things, such as things in our daily lives. Therefore, with the basic understanding of concepts and laws of physics, we are able to notice transformation within day-to-day activities.